so we'll see.
Yeah.
Jessica also shares that she's super Christian.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah, this part.
What?
This part, it got on my nerves.
What happened?
You know how they were talking about. Okay, so she said, I'm super Christian, and, you know, how do you feel about that? And his answer was, holy fucking shit, we're the same person.
Now, he did say that, yeah.
I just feel like if you are going to answer someone who is super Christian, that maybe holy fucking shit isn't the answer that you're gonna respond with, especially if it's that you have that in common with them.
Mm-hmm.
Also, they seem to have a very surface discussion about going to church and raising their kids in a religious home, mm-hmm. and not actually their relationship with Christ.
Mm.
So that kind of got on my nerves.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know if I'm annoyed with Jessica and Mark or if I'm annoyed with production, but I'm annoyed with somebody about that whole conversation, how it was laid out.
I mean, probably Jessica and Mark, because Mark even... No, because Mark even was like, me too, and was like, I have a tattoo on my ribs of a cross.
Yeah.
And was like, yeah, I have my family's initials, and I'm leaving the bottom for my future kids or mm-hmm. whatever. And it's like, okay, that's all great and dandy, but, like, let's talk about your relationship to Christ.
Right.
Like, that's... When you say, I'm Christian too, cool, yes. Let's talk about that. I don't want to hear about your tattoo.
No.
And how you've left the bottom for the kids and the few, like...
That's fine. That's great.
That's not telling me much about your relationship to...
Your faith.
Your actual faith, yeah.
What you actually worship, because I have dated guys who... are Christian, who have prayed with me, who definitely worship money and pussy. What do you actually worship?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Right.
But, you know, that's fine. Jessica and Mark, you all just have this nice conversation about absolutely nothing.
So, yeah, they talk about that. Jessica, she heads back to the ladies and, you know, says that Mark is... the guy she seems to be most into, even though he meets zero of the criteria that she mm-hmm. came in there with.
Yeah.
And the fact that he's 24, you know, she's obviously worried about the age gap.
Mm-hmm.
But she does say that, you know, Mark and I are creating a true soul connection.
Yeah.
Is what she called it. But you could tell she's already in her head wondering about, like, her fam. She said, like, what are her family and friends going to think?
Right, right.
What's society going to think? Mm-hmm. Mark is 5 years younger than her baby brother, who is 5 years younger than her.
Yeah.
So that is, like, a mind fuck.
Yeah, it is. She shouldn't care, but yeah.
She shouldn't care, but she cares, obviously. Yeah. Now, Jessica and Barnett... Even though Jessica's hitting it off of Mark.
Yeah, yeah.
Her and Barnett are still very much a thing.
Mm-hmm.
There's definitely a connection there.
Which is interesting now that you say that it's a choice.
What?
They didn't, like, make everybody rotate for however long. Like,
right, they ended up choosing after a while who they wanted to spend time with.
That's interesting that Miss Messica decided to choose both of these people for this long.
Right.
Interesting. Okay.
And two very different people. Yeah,
very different people.
Very different
people. We're going to get to that in a moment.
We're going to get it. Mm-hmm. So Barnett, you know, asks her if you're married, you know, what kind of life do you want to come home to?
Mm-hmm.
Which I appreciate. The one thing I appreciate about this question, this show,
mm-hmm.
even though we obviously don't see all their conversations in depth, like we didn't see Mark and Jessica's full relation, like conversation about religion or whatever.
Yeah.
But we do get to see and hear the topics and questions that they do dive into in a way that we don't see on The Bachelor.
Yes.
Like on The Bachelor, true. I assume that Peter had a conversation with Madison about a deeper conversation about Christianity or whatnot, but we don't actually see any of those conversations. Or we get frustrated watching The Bachelor, like, why aren't they talking about what they see in the future? Like, what kind of marriage they want? We never see those, like, deep dives into those conversations.
Yeah.
But I like on this show, they actually, like, show them at least attempting those conversations.
Right, true.
So, yeah, Barnett asked a great question. If you're married, like, what kind of life do you want to come home to? What do you envision? And Jessica didn't really give them much of a in-depth answer.
No, but she was just like, you on the couch.
Yeah.
You on the couch, which is aggressive because she's talking about how she makes the best Italian beef and she's going to go home and be so peppy and nice and happy.
Mm-hmm.
Girl, if you come home from a terrible day and your husband's sitting there like, hey, and there's no food in the fridge, there's not a dish washed, there's not a nothing, you're going to be upset.
Right.
Just say your real answer.
Mm. Yeah. She just wants a man.
No, that's crazy.
That's what, but honestly, I think this answer she gives is the answer. Yeah, she just wants a man.
Yeah.
That's it. I want to come home and he's laying on the couch. Yeah. She didn't give no particulars, mm-hmm. no nothing. She literally is just looking for a man, which is her first where she done goofed. Because you need more than that, girl.
You need a partner.
You need a partner, like, right.
Oh my
Not
God.
Just some man, any man.
Yeah.
You know, Joe Schmo laying on the couch.
Hey guys, that's a little taste of this week's episode. If you want to hear the full recap,
head on over to patreon.com/twoblackgirlsonerose and sign up to get weekly recaps and other Bachelor content from us.
See you next week.